Honorable Member Blong, not fly.
Maybe it's an appropriate time to ask a supplementary, but Babi Putim was a new black question. Thank you, Speaker. Asking Blomegolo Education Minister, let me give some brief explanation. Me, like, am by explaining between a school fee and a project fee. Project fee is what the school board are imposing to get necessary infrastructure, kind of a classroom, toilet, planty or something. Now, let's be realistic that project fees are a very, very important component. Now, planty school, they are very successful because they impose their own fees. You by looking at all private schools, all missing run schools, those that have done well. I'll take example of my school, St. Gabriel Long District Blomi. I'm come up number one law recent selection in Shiloh County, top ranking, because they have their own fees. Now, this is how it works. Their operation fee for an annual is about 1.5 million. Now, you compare a school kind of say, Mogulu or Antablo Nomad, and by costing 2.5 million the operation run. So how do we justify in terms of operation law school? Fees, I mean, not enough. That's why the schools are going to look after ways for how about only operating school law all. Or seminar, we need to come up with the rationale. How are we come up with, you may come up with a figure. Are we standardizing across? Because different schools got plenty headband law yet. And it's very, very difficult. So can the minister, through his department, make it clear? Now, no, maybe you seem to can ratio or calculating. Or do we give a fair treatment across for everyone? That has to be clarified for all the schools across. Otherwise, some of the schools, money you may give him to me talk to you. And by, you know, end up operating, operation run for school the whole year. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Honorable Minister of Law Education.
Thank you, Minister. Thank you, Speaker, Mr. Speaker. Now, thank you for a good question, blow. Remember, blow not fly. All right, all got a fees, where project fees, National Education Board is approving. Now, that's not, I mean, per child, 118 blow pickinini. Now, so as example, elementary was 20 kina, or high school was 200 kina. You see the fee limits. The calculations are based on this one. The pay National Education Board approval fees. Now you by looking at the same national fee. Suppose you calculate it, you get some figures. For one all students, a total number of students per school. Now me like talking my country now, you may get this is the approved fee. They rank it, they put it under project fees. That is the one the government is setting up away from our parents. People are offloading the parents. But you will find that that is not enough for a double-story classroom or six-in-one classroom or big block kind of same or big block this law. So we encourage the schools, if you have bigger projects, you can also apply through PIP or your member or DDA. You come under that and you subsidize from there. But these fees are basically we got from what the education department is giving us as per child, a fair Pickinini, Ed Block Pickinini, one time all fees, is approved by the National Education Board. So that's why the government is saying we must use our DSIP money as well, identify projects in our schools, in our health centers. At the same time, you may look long, training long all schools to upgrade them to qualify 166 drive, and also resourcing the schools in terms of producing teaching and learning materials and things like that. So me encouraging you, me all members, we assist the schools and identify some projects, and we help our community grow together. And it's not the education business, the education department's business alone. And collectively, everyone must contribute to the school administration and projects for you, me long. Country bring me. Mr. Speaker, thank you.
Ormola. Member Blong.